The 90s were a time we can look back on with equal parts embarrassment and awe. It gave us stars who are still A-listers to this day. Of course, I'm talking about legends like Britney Spears, Mariah Carey, Beyoncé, Jennifer Lopez, and Justin Timberlake. But there are some 90s stars who moved on to other ventures. Here's a look at seven of those musicians and where they are today. The latter half of the decade was the era of the boy band. One of those groups was none other than 98 Degrees. They had a quick rise to the top with romantic hits like The Hardest Thing and I Do Cherish You. Unfortunately for fans, the band took a hiatus in 2003, and most of the members laid low while Nick Lachey gave us Emmy worthy television content with newlyweds Nick and Jessica. The show was about his then marriage with Jessica Simpson, and I'm telling you, tuna fish was never the same again. If you know, you know. Anywho, I digress. The band finally reunited in 2012 and released a brand new album the year after, and even gave us a Christmas album in 2017. They've since gone on a few headlining tours and have a recurring gig at Disney World. Brandy was one of the biggest talents from the 90s, getting a recording contract at the tender age of 14. Now, she only put out two albums in the decade, but both were hugely successful. She was also responsible for one of the bigger mysteries of 1998. Who did the boy belong to, Brandy or Monica? Anyway, Brandy stayed active in the entertainment industry, including a pretty stellar acting career. In 2010, she enjoyed a resurgence with an appearance on Dancing with the Stars, and in 2015, she made her Broadway debut in the musical Chicago. You couldn't go far in 1997 without hearing Mbop, the song that turned Hanson into overnight international sensations. Their careers afterward took a surprising turn. They left their label and went independent in the early 2000s because an executive rejected over 80 songs they'd written. Since then, they've released seven albums, embarked on several world tours, and still have a dedicated fan base. Remember Barbie Girl, the wildly inappropriate song that young teens sang along to without knowing what they were really singing? Yeah, that was by a group called Aqua, the Danish group responsible for one of the most catchy and successful songs of the 90s, but they seem to have disappeared after Barbie Girl took the world by storm. Unfortunately, they were unable to recapture that success, and they disbanded in 2001. In 2008, they had a reunion tour followed by a new album called Megalomaniac in 2011. In 2017, they had another reunion celebrating the 20th anniversary of Barbie Girl. Three words that'll take you straight back to the year 1999, Mambo Number 5. Who can forget this hit by Playboy Lou Bega? While Lou's popularity in the States declined, his appeal in Europe remained pretty strong as his next three albums charted in various countries. In 2019, he returned to the spotlight with his first song since 2013, a remix of sorts of the 1994 song Scatman. The name of the song is Scatman and Hatman. Yeah, we're confused as well. Don't worry. Eiffel 65 released one song at the end of the 90s, and that song has become an anthem for the decade. Of course, I'm talking about Blue, Dabba-Dee, Dabba-Dye, the catchy-as-hell song that put the Italian band on the map, and they stayed together until 2005. They disbanded when one of the members wanted to explore a solo career. The remaining two members started a new band called Bloom 06. They all reunited in 2010, making new music and touring throughout Europe. Next up, one of the most successful Swedish groups of all time, Ace of Base. From The Sign to All That She Wants, they've released some iconic bops, but what happened to them? After 2002, they only released one studio album in 2010, but that was without Lynn and Jenny Berggren, who left the band in 2007 and 2009, respectively. While they've never officially broken up, most of the activity from the band has been the release of several compilation albums. Who were some of your favorite musicians from the 90s? Let us know on Twitter and Facebook.